Let's go and recap what we've done so far. So we were interested in solving this boundary value problem. And what we had was that the boundary conditions which are given are y sub 0 is equal to 0 and y sub 9 is equal to 0. But since we are solving this problem by using shooting method, we cannot use the boundary conditions to solve the problem. We have to use initial conditions. And since we need two initial conditions because it's a second order differential equation, we have one initial condition at x equal to 0, but we don't have the other initial condition on the slope of y. So what we did was we said, hey, let's go and assume y sub 0 equal to 4. And we're going to use Euler's method. So these, I'm just recapping what we've done so far. So we said, let's go ahead and use the y prime of 0 equal to 4 and figure out how close it comes to y sub 9 equal to 0. And we used Euler's method and we used h equal to 3, which implies that you are taking 3 steps to go to 9, from 0 to 3. So you're basically starting at 0, going to 3, going to 6, and going to 9 by using Euler's method. And based on that, what we obtained was that the value of y sub 3, which we got, y sub 3, we got it equal to 1548. And that is the approximate value of y at 9, which we got by using the Euler's method of the step size of 3. Now, as you can see that this is not anywhere close to y sub 9 being equal to 0, this 1548. So what we have to do is we have to use some kind of a hit and trial method here to now choose a different value for the starting slope at x equal to 0. So we chose y prime 0 equal to 4. This was totally arbitrary the way I chose my initial guess for the slope. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to choose another guess for the slope and see that what kind of values I get for the y. So I'm going to choose y prime of 0 equal to, so I'm going to write down here, choose y prime of 0 equal to minus 24. And you go to go, what you have to do is you have to go through the steps of, Euler's method, just like we did for y prime of 0 equal to 4. So I'm not going to show you the 3 steps which I'm going to take. I'm just going to give you the results for those. So you again go through the steps of Euler's method by starting with y prime of 0 equal to minus 24 and y of 0 equal to 0, because that's already given to us with those two conditions. And this is what you're going to get. And if you follow exactly the same procedure as we had for the previous assumption of what y prime of 0 is. So it's I, this is x of I, this is y sub I, and this is z sub I. For 0, x of I is 0, y sub I is 0, z sub I is minus 24, because that's what I'm assuming it to be. Then when I choose I equal to 1, then x sub I will be 3. The y sub I which I'll get is minus 72, and this will be minus 24. And then when I go for I equal to 2, x will be 6. I get minus 144 here, and I get minus 24 here. And this is just coincidence that you're getting these values here to be the same. Then 3, I'm getting 9 and minus 216. So what you're finding out is that y sub 3, which you're getting now, is minus 216. And this is the approximate value of y at 9. So you are getting a negative value now. Previously, you got a positive value. You're getting a negative value now. So what I can do is I can continue doing this process of choosing a different value for y prime of 0. So let me go back here. So in order to be able to get y sub 3 as close as possible to 0, which is y sub 9, I can choose a different value for y prime of 0 and continue this process till I find that it's close to 0, the value of y sub 9. But what I can do is I can also do some kind of an interpolation technique to be able to come up with a better initial guess for y prime of 0. So how do I go about doing that?